Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. In today's video, we are going to go over how to create a visualization in CODESYS for our CR displays. So, let's get started. In our last video, we showed you how to bring your sensor process data into your CODESYS program. So in your current CODESYS program, you already have your visualization manager and Visu default uploaded when you added your IFM CR display template. So now to add a new visualization into your program, you'll go to the left-hand side where it says Application and you will right-click. You will then go to where it says Add Object and you will go down to Visualization. Here you will give it a meaningful name and press Add. So once you've added your visualization, you will see the following screen. The white blank space represents the display of the CR that you will be able to use. If you right-click on it and click on Background, you can then click on Use Image and click on the three dots to the right. This will pull up all of the templates that we offer for our CR displays. In this example, we are going to use the Button and Background 7-inch light template, so I will highlight that and click OK. I will then click OK again, and you will see that it has given me a white background with six gray squares to the right, which will represent the buttons of the CR display. So now if you go over to the bottom right corner, you will see a tab that says Visualization Toolbox. If you click on this, the following toolbox will appear. In this video, we are going to click on Basic, and you will drag a rectangle object over into your CR display area. You will now see the properties appear on the right, and if you open up the text property, you will type %.2f, which stands for two decimal places floating point for a real value. And you will press Enter, and you will see it appear in the rectangle in your CR display area. So now if you click on your rectangle again to pull up the properties for that object and navigate to where it says Text Variables, this is where you can add the path to your sensor's process data. In this video, I'm using a PI pressure sensor. So if you double click on where it says text variables, you will see the three dots appear on the right hand side, and you can click on this to navigate to your sensor data. So you will click on applications to expand it. You will then expand your IO-Link master, and you will expand the function block of your sensor. In this video, it is a PI2798. So I'll expand that and scroll down to where it says R pressure, which would be the pressure process data for this sensor. So I will click on that and press OK. And then you'll press Enter. And then I'm going to go back into my visualization toolbox and drag a rectangle over to the left of the previous rectangle. And I'm going to go back to where it says text and type in real pressure data and press Enter. In the property section of your rectangle object, you can also change the background color and font color of these objects. If you go to text properties, you will see that it is defaulted to a black color. If you double click on this, a drop-down window will appear and you can change the color. For example, I will change real pressure data's font color to orange. Now I'll press Enter and you can see that it has changed on the screen. Also, if you hold the Shift button and click on both rectangle objects, you can go to the top where it says align top, and if you click on that, it'll align the objects so that they are even with each other. Now we will go over how to change the visualization using a hotkey configuration and an input configuration. First, we will go over the hotkey configuration. For the CR1077, there are six push buttons on the right-hand side of the display. So if we go into the Visu default, you will see the six buttons on the right-hand side. To get to the hotkey configuration, you will click on this drop-down arrow, and then you will click on hotkeys configuration. If you double-click on the key column, you will see a drop-down appear. For this example, I'm going to click on the F1 button. You will then select key down, and you can select action type, and another drop-down will appear. And we are going to select Change Shown Visualization, And then in the action, you can click on the three dots to the right of the assign. And we are going to select process data and press OK and press Enter. So this means when we click on the F1 hotkey button to the right of the CR display, it'll take us to our PI process data that we set up in the previous visualization. Now we will show you how to change the visualization using the input configuration. You will have to go back to the visualization that you just created. You will then go back into the visualization toolbox, and this time we are going to go to the common control section, and we are going to drag a button into your CR display area. Once the properties of this button appear, we will go to the text and we will select visu_default, because this is a button that will take you back to the previous default template. So once you have selected that, we will scroll down to where it says input configuration, and we are going to select the one that says on mouse down. If you click on that, a window will appear, and you have the actions you can select on the left-hand side. In this example, we are going to click on change shown visualization and take it over to the right-hand side. You will then click on the three dots next to the assign button, and you will select Visu Default and select OK, and select OK again. So now you have your button created to take you back to the Visu Default template from your visualization screen. Next, if you'd like to add the current date and time to your CR display screen, you can do this by going back to the Basics tab, dragging a rectangle onto the CR display area, and then going into the text section and typing the following. So this will allow the CR to display the current date and time on the screen. Now that you have your visualization created and your hotkey configuration and input configurations created, you can now build your project. Once it is built, you can then log in to download the program to your CR display. And once you are logged in, you can click the Start button. So now let me take you to the CR display to show you the visualization we just created. So here you can see our CR1077 display with our CODESYS project loaded onto it. In our CODESYS project, we set up the hotkey configuration. So now if I press on the F1 button to the right of the display, it'll take us into the visualization that we created. In this visualization, you can see the current date and time in the top right corner, as well as the real process data in the orange font that we set up, and the current PI process data updating in real time. So now if I press on the Visu Default button, it'll take us back to the main display of the template that we created. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on creating a visualization in your CODESYS program for our CR displays. As always, you can check out our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.